A warm welcome to you all to this presentation. Today we are going to talk about motifs, a tool for analyzing the folk tales. It is very interesting topic to discuss in the tribal studies and the cultural studies. First of all, before going into the what is motif and folktale and all, we need to have a certain understanding on the folktale, where it stands in the discipline of folklore or folkloristics, right? So folktales, it is part and parcel of folk narratives. There we can find there are three types of folk narratives. We can divide into three types. The folk narratives can be divided into three parts, right? One is prose narratives, another one is verse narratives, the third one is fixed phrase narratives. The prose narratives again is divided into three parts. It is known as one is myth, another one is legend, and folk tales. Okay, then verse narratives. Under the verse narratives, folk songs, ballads, and folk epics are found here. And then our fixed phrase narratives. It is proverbs, riddles, and tongue twisters. So our concentrated area is folk tales, which is come under the prose narratives part. Okay, the folk narrative, folk tales. Again, we can make a types in the folk tales. The types, as you see the table, you can see that there are so many classification so far have been dealt on the folk tales. Okay, throughout the world, like from American anthropologists and folklorists, and even European folklorists, even Indian folklorists, have done so many work on the folktales classifications. After the collection, the classification comes. The chapter A to Z, they have made it an alphabetical classification. As you can see the table, chapter A, creation and the natural behavior, the B, animals, chapter C, forbidden objects, and chapter D, magic related tales, and E, death, resurrection, ghost, incarnation, etc., and F, surprising events and characteristics, places, characters, and places traveled to the other world, G, terrifying animals and witches, and H is trial, and J is knowledge, cleverness, and it goes, each and every letters, you can also read that. And is it many sub-classification? So it is, again, given the chance to upcoming scholars to make a, enormous, types of classification. So that's what it is made, that there is a chapter Z is made as a many sub-classification. Again, it will go in deeper. Okay, that now we have seen that how the classification has made in that, into the table. And now we will look into the tools for analyzing folk tales. Actually, this tale type was introduced by Antti Aarne in 1910. It was revised and published by Smith Thompson, an American folklorist and anthropologist, in 1928 and 1961. For Antti Aarne used the code A. Okay, when the revision happened, after that, Smith Thompson used A-T, Antti Aarne and Smith Thompson, that word used. So Smith Thompson, in his second edition in 1961, divided tales according to the animal tales and ordinary folk tales. And again, he has made sub themes. like, you know, for example, Animal Tales, he has made a number, you know, he has given that number, Animal Tales 12299. You know, 12299 tales, classified tales, 12299 means it is all, you know, animal tales. And ordinary folk tales, 300 to 1199. Okay, within the 300 to 1199 tales is are considered like, you know, the classified as ordinary folk tales. And another one is humorous and tales from experience. That number is 1200 to 1999. Okay, then formula tales 2400 to 2499. So it goes in that way. Okay, well, then there will be a question, how this classification has been made. Okay, so how the Steve Thompson has done on the classification, how could he do it, right? So now we can have again the one more analyzing part, you know. Steve Thompson, he has made that, you know, to find motif in a folk tale, the when we find motif in a folk tale, according to that motif only we can make a classification of folk tale, right? So without finding that motif in a folk tale, one cannot easily do the classification. First we need to have identified, right? So for motif, what Steve Thompson defines is the smallest element in a tale having a power to persist in tradition. This is the definition which was given by Steve Thompson. Motif, the smallest element in a tale having a power to persist in a tradition. So now again he has explained, motif will be having three parts: the character of the tale, items that work behind the action, right, and single instance. So this is the formula for identifying the folk motif. Okay, first one, what he said is the smallest element in a tale having power to persist in a tradition, that is called motif. Then how the motif you know identifies means, it's a character of the tale, and items that work behind the action, it will be having that single instances. Okay, so now we will conclude that you know this session by saying motif and tale type are the units of folk narratives. That is one. Then concept of motif has a universal standard. Okay, that will be having that universal standard. Tale types are related to specific cultural areas. So that without that cultural context, it has no meaning, right? The folk tale has no meaning. A tale type indexes a tale as a whole. Tale type indexes a tale as a whole. It sees them. The theme, whereas in the case of motif, the factors of narration that are indexed. With all the differences, tale type and motif index are similar and also complementary to each other. Okay, so I have dealt with this motif with some examples, and experts and scholars and fellowship in the field of folklore states. And if you have any queries and questions, please ask me. Thank you.